What up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Wine Wednesday. I am your host, Jaytan Gunter, owner of Grapes and Sam Publishing. As you can see, there is wine in my glass, so I'll be doing a review. We definitely have a special wine today. Just been staying busy and trying to drink as much wine and bring as much content to you guys as of late. For people who have been rocking with me thus far, I do appreciate you. I could not have gone this far without you. And then for people who are brand new, I hope to get some questions in the comment section. I hope to get some DMs about wine. I'm always here to help, always here to educate. If you have not gotten a chance, check out my, I have two podcasts going on right now that I'm just setting up. Well, one is already rocking, but one is going to be coming up. Check out my Step Up to the Palate. You can see it on almost every podcast platform. And it's Step Up to the Palate. It's between me and Scott Hairston. He's an ex-MLB baseball pro player. And he's getting into wine, and I'm trying to walk him through how to, pass the first level of becoming a sommelier. Because he's already in the industry, but he wants to go further on the education side. And so we're going over different types of grapes, different types of things that he needs to know to pass the test. And so go check that out, Step Up to the Palate on any platform. And then the other one we've been collaborating already, but I'm going to be taking it into a podcast realm. Is Total Winos with my guy Sean Brady of Regular Wine Guy. So as you can see, there's a lot going on. Stay tuned for that one because that's going to be dropping into podcast land soon. But you guys are not here for me to ramble. You guys are here for the wine, of course. And again, I have a really cool one I've never reviewed on this area in the world. Today, my peoples, we are in Armenia. Yes, Armenia. Over 6,000 years of winemaking in this area. So old world for real, but a lot of people don't know about them unless you have been to Armenia. I just happen to be a wine nerd. I taste everything, I try everything, and I've had a couple Armenian wines before that I loved. This one is outstanding, so I'm looking forward to breaking this down for you on camera. Today we're talking about the Karas. It's a red blend, 2017. I want you guys to see that label so you guys can know what to look for. When you go check it out, I'm actually going to tell you where this is at, so you can go check it out. This is a blend. So again, we have Syrah, which is 35% Syrah. We have 35% Cot, which is Malbec. It's another name for Malbec. We have 20% Cabernet Franc, and then we have 10% Tannat. So this is going to be interesting. I'm looking forward to tasting this with you guys on camera. I tasted a little bit already, and I was like, okay, we're reviewing this. Sorry about that. Let's get right into it. On the nose. So I'm definitely getting berries. I'm getting mixed berries. I'm getting a little bit of blackberry, raspberry going on here. Some blueberries. It's like a mixed berry bag. Definitely a lot of berries jumping out. I'm getting a little sun-kissed soil, so like a little bit of hot, if you're walking out on a very hot day on a farm, that kind of sun-kissed earthiness is jumping out of the glass at me. There's like old leather mitt here too, like an old baseball mitt that's been broken in. Definitely getting that on the nose. A little bit of an herbal thing going on here, green herbs, like a cardamom spice too, so there's some spice here. There's also a bit of a floral component, like a something interesting, something unique. Let me see. Maybe like violets. I'm getting a little bit of like a violet play on the nose. Interesting. Let's see if everything's translating to the palate. Yeah, this is mixed bag of berries like all over the palate. Hits initial. It's fruit forward up front. But this is pure fruit. This is not like any like fakey, like flavor or like texture. This is pure fruit. I'm getting blueberries and raspberries are the ones that are dominant up front. Very dry on the outside, so like medium tannin, but like there's also like this, it's drying tannins, but they're not overly dry, and it's not overly tannic at all. This is very approachable red wine, one that you can drink by itself or pair with food. It has this like, it has this savoriness that I'm catching on the finish. Very long finish. By the way, this is coming from volcanic soil, so you're getting a little bit of that kind of, you're getting a little bit of that texture going on here. This is smooth as silk on the palate. It's beautiful wine. It has like this like nice little pencil lead thing going on the third quarter to the finish. Kind of that spice and kind of white pepper thing going on the third quarter to the finish. So you're getting a lot more of the savory characteristics popping in on the third quarter. The acid here is medium plus. The acid is here. As you can see, I'm expecting right as I'm talking. This is outstanding wine. I highly recommend this wine. Highly. And I actually found this at, and you know I normally on Wine Wednesday don't tell you where I find wines, but I just want you guys to go check this out. I want you guys to expand your palate. This is a great wine to do it with. Armenian wine. You can find this at Total Wines. I found this for under $15. Outstanding wine. I highly recommend it for anybody who's really into trying to expand their palate, trying to learn a little bit more about wine and about old regions of wine too. Again, this is 6,000 years of winemaking in this area. And this Caras is outstanding wine. The region is called Armavir. So go check that out. Do your research. If you know something more about Armenian wine, I would love to get more information on these wines. Because, again, I've only had one or two prior to this. So I would love to get more information if you're somebody who's tasted a lot of Armenian wine. Because, okay, I also want to expand my palate. So, let's go. Anyway, hope everybody's having a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful week. Hope this is the perfect episode to get you over the hump day to the rest of the week. And my question of the day, have you ever had Armenian wine? It doesn't matter whether it's red or white. I'm just curious if anybody knows a lot about Armenian wine. I would love to like trade notes back and forth. So anyway, till next time, guys. Cheers.